Hello student, today we discuss about analysis of variance for fixed effect model in case of one-way classification. The mathematical model considered in one-way classification is yij equal to mu plus alpha I plus epsilon ij, I is equal to 1 to k, j equal to 1 to h. Ni, 1 to ni, where yij is the jth response of the jth unit receiving ith treatment, mu is the general mean effect given by mu is equal to summation ni mu I divided by n, and alpha I is the effect due to ith treatment and it is equal to mu I minus mu. And epsilon ij is the error effect due to chance. The assumptions in this model are all the observations yijs are all independent and these yijs follow normal with mean mu I variance sigma e square, and different effects are additive in nature. Also the error effect eij epsilon ij follows normal with mean 0 and variance sigma e square. Now let's consider statistical analysis of this model. Actually here we have to estimate or you have to find or you have to test the equality of population means, that is the homogeneity of different treatment effects. So we write the null hypothesis H naught as mu 1 equal to mu 2 equal to mu k, or else in terms of alpha we can write the null hypothesis as alpha 1 equal to alpha 2 equal to alpha k equal to 0, as alpha I is equal to mu I minus mu. Then the alternative hypothesis here is that at least two of the means or the parameters here, two treatment means mu 1 to mu k are different. Alternative hypothesis is that at least two of the means mu 1 to mu k are different. So now let's write yij, yi dot bar, this is mean of the class, different class, ith class, this is equal to summation yij summation over j, j is equal to 1 to ni divided by ni. This is the mean of the ith class. The overall mean y double dot bar is equal to double summation yij by n, I is equal to 1 to k and j is equal to 1 to ni. This is the overall mean and this is the mean of ith class. Now let us find least square estimates of the parameters, namely mu and alpha I. The parameters mu and alpha I are estimated by using the principle of least squares, that is minimizing the error sum of squares, that is E is equal to double summation epsilon ij square. From this we can observe that epsilon ij is equal to double summation yij minus mu minus alpha I whole square, I is equal to 1 to k and j is equal to 1 to ni. This is done by partially differentiating E with respect to mu and equating it to 0. We get a normal equation. Further differentiating E with respect to alpha I and equating it to 0, we get the normal equations to estimate mu and alpha I. So now differentiating partially E with respect to mu and equating it to 0, this is equal to 2 double summation yij minus mu minus alpha I, as a coefficient of mu is minus 1, this is equal to 0, implies double summation yij is equal to n mu plus summation ni alpha I, as a summation over j is equal to 1 to ni, it becomes summation ni. And from this, we can observe here summation ni alpha I is equal to 0. Since alpha I is equal to mu I minus mu. So this becomes 0. So from this we can write that mu hat, that the estimation of mu, is equal to double summation yij divided by n. This is nothing but y double dot bar overall mean. Further, differentiating E with respect to alpha I and equating it to 0, we get this is equal to summation yij minus mu minus alpha I into minus and then minus 1, and then it is with respect to alpha I, so we are considering the summation over j is equal to 1 to ni. This is equal to 0, implies we get summation yij summation over j is equal to 1 to ni minus, this becomes ni into mu minus summation alpha I equal to 0, summation over I is equal to 1 to ni. From this we have summation yij is equal to ni into mu minus summation alpha So ni into mu plus alpha I equal to summation yij dividing by ni. Summation yij by ni is equal to mu plus alpha I, so that alpha I is equal to, this is nothing but yi dot bar minus mu hat is equal to y bar. So alpha I cap is equal to yi dot bar minus y bar, and these are the estimates, least square estimates of two parameters mu and alpha I.